Whether you love it or hate it, Apple's Dynamic Island is the most talked about feature on the new iPhone. It looks like a very creative way of solving their problem regarding the top notch. Android has already ditched the notch a long time ago, and Apple fans were keen to see their preferred brand finally do it too. While Dynamic Island has been praised as a great fusion of hardware and software, there are some issues with it, and we're here to tell you all about it. So let's begin with the elephant in the room. Dynamic Island takes up more vertical space than the classic notch. As soon as the new iPhone was launched, several websites showed visual representation of how the island cuts even more into the display. The whole point of introducing the island in the first place was to maximize the amount of usable screen. While Apple has increased the screen-to-body ratio with the new iPhone Pro, it's not really maximized the amount of usable screen space. One could even go as far as saying that the Dynamic Island takes up more vertical space than its predecessor, because, let's be honest, who can use the space above the island anyway? Striking out like a sore thumb and distracting its customers when watching full-screen content is not something Apple was necessarily going for, but here we are. However, many believe that the new Dynamic Island concept is not made to last. Since Apple is already working on an under-display Face ID, customers will soon see more changes done to the design of the iPhone. The same people argue that Apple transitioned to the Dynamic Island just so that they would offer some tangible design change, since the rest of the phone seems to be pretty much the same as the last one. Since Dynamic Island is probably not made to last, then it makes sense why its functionality is quite limited. So that way, when it will be removed, it won't be missed that much. Another main complaint is that users very easily get fingerprints all over the camera. Not only is Dynamic Island more intrusive than the traditional notch, but it's also constantly drawing your attention. It looks alive with fancy animations, and the only way you can interact with the Dynamic Island is with touch inputs. You'll find yourself poking this cutout a lot throughout the day, meaning you're also touching the selfie camera or the area surrounding it. Now, you might say, just avoid touching the camera, it's that easy. But accidental touches will still happen. Will it necessarily ruin your pictures? No. But it will degrade the camera ever so slightly compared to other iPhones. This brings us to our next point, reachability. Apple's new iPhones are big, especially when you compare them to the sizes from just a few years ago. Dynamic Island is located at the top of the display, which is arguably one of the most difficult parts to reach when you're using your phone with just one hand. And let's be honest, 90% of the time we use the phone with just one hand. It's easy to say that if you can't reach it, then just ignore it, but that is the problem. The Dynamic Island is built in such a way that you cannot ignore it. There are constant animations, notifications, and whatnot that will capture your attention and make you want to interact with it, even if you can't reach it. And lastly, and probably the most important point of this video today, is the usefulness of Dynamic Island. When you give it a closer look, Apple's Dynamic Island does not bring anything new to the table. It just gives a new look to already existing features. According to Apple, Dynamic Island should be used for tracking tasks and live events that have a defined beginning and end by presenting only the most essential content. The live activity displayed by the Dynamic Island should update only when new content is available, alerting people only if it's essential to get their attention, and should give people control over beginning and ending it. So, is the Dynamic Island really needed? All this live activity tracking can easily be done through other ways which wouldn't clog your display. Speaking of how useful or not the Dynamic Island is, we find that it's important to mention that there aren't at this current moment in time many apps that support and give you Dynamic Island experiences. Sure, first-party apps such as Timer, Apple Music, and Apple Maps are supported and can give you great Dynamic Island experiences, but so far, the app island interaction is quite limited. And let's be honest, who would even use the Dynamic Island for the Timer app or Apple Maps? For music, it makes sense. It gives you a way to skip between songs and whatnot, while also reading an article, browsing the internet, or doing other activities that you normally do on a smartphone. With its limited functionality, it's hard to imagine why Apple went for this design change. That is not to say that the Dynamic Island doesn't have potential. In fact, it could turn into a great thing if third-party developers find a way to integrate it into their user experiences and make use of it. But so far, Dynamic Island just manages to hide the two unappealing cutouts on the front of the iPhone 14 Pro. This is something that could have easily been achieved through other means, though. What do you think of the new Dynamic Island? Is it a feature that you enjoy and use? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below.